Good morning, Internet. Today we're going to talk about personal freedom and financial freedom. There are many people who have financial freedom, but they're trapped. They're trapped in their little world. They're trapped in perhaps their job. They're trapped in perhaps part of their lifestyle because the finances are there, but the internal fulfillment, the internal joy, that's not there. Someone left a comment on my channel talking about, quote, the great ones never ever let you know their political affiliation. Bill Gates is a Democrat. I think he's in the fourth or fifth richest person in the world. I would consider that great. Michael Bloomberg, another billionaire, Democrat. He's pretty great. The person who left this comment is misinformed, and this person's trying to shame me or format me around to their way of thinking because they have this little thought.
If it was me in that position, I would behave this way.
Once again, let me say this. If it was me in this position, I would behave this way. So number one, they're not in this position. Number two, they're not making this kind of money. Number three, they're not living this life, but they have advice for me. One of the things that I've discovered and learned a long, long time ago, regardless of what you do, there will be people who will like you. There will be people who will hate you. Doesn't matter. You could be Mother Teresa, you have detractors. You can be Hitler, you have fans. Does not matter. And one of the big problems that I've had with some of you, because most of you are legit, most of you are buying what I am selling, you're changing your mindsets, you're doing stuff, you're saving money, you're putting your self aside, meaning you're going for delayed gratification. One guy, he's saving $1,000 a month. So there are many of you who see the lifestyle that I have, who see the things that I've done, because I do show receipts, and you're going like, I can get with that. But there's a certain group of you who are haters, who are jealous because your accomplishments pale in comparison to mine. And if that's elitist, so be it, because it's also, or as they like to say in the internet, facts. I think that's facts, right? I want to educate you on, first of all, I'm not a Democrat. I've never been a Democrat. I'm not a Republican. I'm an independent. I have voted, except for this last election, I have voted a mixed ticket. Some Republicans, some Democrats. I typically try to flesh out who's the best person for the job, who reflects what I want the body politic to do. First of all, I'm not a Democrat. I've never been a Democrat. I'm not a Republican. I'm an independent. I have voted, except for this last election, I have voted a mixed ticket. Some Republicans, some Democrats. I typically try to flesh out who's the best person for the job, who reflects what I want the body politic to do. This is the first time in my life I have voted a straight Democratic ticket because I'll say this and I'll be very political. There is something wrong with some of you Trump people. I think the people who voted for Trump because they didn't like Hillary are gone. They're like, I have made a mistake. I was bamboozled. I was sold a bad bill of goods. But there's a certain group of you who are mentally ill because anytime someone says something about a president who is melting down, whose policies has cost businesses millions, whose policies has cost Americans jobs, yet you're still riding with this fool. Yeah, I said that. Because I have personal freedom and I have economic freedom. You ever wonder how someone can be rich? I'm talking about multi-millions of dollars in the bank. I believe Kate Spade, Kurt Cobain, these people literally had it all financially, but they did not have personal wealth. There was something missing, there was something wrong, and it led these people to in their lives. And they had all this money. I don't know what happened to a Kate Spade, a Kurt Cobain, an Amy Winehouse. I don't know. There was something missing. There was something wrong. And it led these people to end their lives. But I do know, as a person who has faced death, it made me change. A lot of the things I used to believe in, I no longer believe in. Because when you almost die, you become crystal clear on what's important and what's not important. So in building financial freedom and personal freedom, I deliberately chose to expose myself, expose the way that I live, expose my viewpoints. If Trump was a wonderful president, I would say he was a wonderful president. He's not. Facts. You know what they say on the internet? These be facts. There are many of you who are so stuck on stupid that you can't even see the lessons that I'm putting for you. Because what is the point in building something, creating a business, so you have to hide who you are to make money? What's the point in that? I don't hide anything. When I started this YouTube channel, I didn't hide my face. I didn't hide what I went through. I didn't hide the fact that I was homeless. I didn't hide none of that stuff, because this creates an environment of personal freedom. I like to call it personal wealth, the ability to be who you are, to live like you want to live, to say what you want to say without financial repercussions, because this is how I built this turkey. This is how I've set all of this up intentionally, because I have seen what happens when, let's say, the gay congressman who votes against gay interests, but in the closet, he's got a young boy or, you know, whatever. And then he's exposed. His career is over. His reputation is ruined. If he had just come out and said, look, I'm gay, I'm going to vote for the gay interest, how do you like me now? He would have been much better. He wouldn't have had this thing in his mind that, what if they find out? What if they find out who I really am? So the person who left that comment, if you would change or trade who you are to get some money, you are a lost soul. In this economy, in this world that we have today, you don't have to do that. There was a time, yeah, you had to play that game, because there were gatekeepers. There were people who made or not made your career. Today, you can be a pornographer. You can be a shock jock. I call it the Howard Stern effect. $400 million contract? And he's being himself. Rush Limbaugh, don't like him. He's being himself. So there are many, many people. Snoop Doggy Dogg, he's being himself. So you don't have to trade who you are to make money. And that's why I say you're a lost soul, because I know what you're trying to do. Just to bring a lot of y'all up to speed, I have been collecting data on comments for years. This is like a little side project. And with a great deal of accuracy, I can predict who's going to become a hater before they become a hater, based upon their earlier comments. Now you, my friend, are on the verge, you're in the middle of being a hater. Because first of all, I should deconstruct your comment. You had the first part that was positive. Let's call that 20%. The other 80% was negative. So when you have 80% negative but 20% positive, because I think that's like you kiss somebody before you screw them, that's pretty much where you are. And what you're missing, all of you Trump people, is, look, let's say you're a Trump person. Come clean with it. Start a podcast, start a YouTube channel, and you will get fans, because there's a lot of you mentally ill people. Yes, I think if you're still riding with Trump, you're mentally ill. There's too much factual evidence to suggest otherwise. You don't care, as D.L. Hughley said, instead of sharing this country, we were to burn it down. Could be. The greater message here is you could be who you are and you could still make a lot of money. You could be who you are and you could still make a lot of money. That's the greater message here. You don't have to hide who you are. You don't have to hide your sexuality. You don't have to do any of that stuff. But people still do, because a lot of people are ashamed of who they are. They're ashamed of what they represent. They're ashamed of their background. They're ashamed of their mom. They're ashamed of their dad. I've talked about my mother and her highly dysfunctional life, because I talk about this stuff. I talk about the fact of having a kid with a woman, and she actually went berserk. She assaulted me. She took me to child support court. I got dismissed. I talk about that because you know why? You will never be able to take those painful moments, those ugly moments, and turn around and go, ha, this is Glendon Cameron. He didn't tell us about that because I already told you. There's a method to the madness here, because if I out myself, no one else can do it. So therefore, it pulls any power away from it. And this is something a lot of people don't seem to understand, especially these people who are fakes, frauds, and posers, that you're living with a lot of stress when you're faking who you are. You don't have to do it. Tiffany Haddish. There's been a lot of smack talking about Tiffany Haddish because she has the audacity to wear the same dress 2, 3, 4 times.
And Tiffany's like, look, I spent $3,000 for this dress. I'm gonna wear it till it falls apart.
She's being herself. Groupon story. She got the deal with Groupon. She's being herself. I forget her name. Ortiz, the congresswoman from New York. She's being herself. And they're succeeding. Snoop Dogg, Ice-T. He made more money from being a detective on television. And this guy created a rap song called Cop Killer, I believe. He's been on that show, what, 20 years? He's had a regular paycheck, a 6 or 7 figure paycheck for 20 years being himself. You don't have to hide. You don't have to submit. These YouTubers, they're being themselves, making money. So I feel that it is the epitome of success to have personal freedom as well as financial freedom. Just to have financial freedom, you can end up dependent upon drugs. You can become an alcoholic because you're hiding who you are. And for you, my dear friend who left that comment, I wonder what you're hiding. I really do. Because as I said in my last video, I don't listen to people who are less successful than I am on how to be successful. That's like learning how to be a dog from a chipmunk. Chipmunk don't know nothing about being a dog. A dog knows about being a dog. Why would I go to a chipmunk to learn how to be a dog? That makes no sense. And that's what a lot of you are doing because of the hate and the jealousy. Because I am a black man in these United States of America, and I did it my way. I can fully represent and be myself, talk about fucking chicks, talk about all of this stuff, and I still get money. I'm still free while you're in prison in a job that you hate. Because I am a black man in these United States of America, and I did it my way. I can fully represent and be myself, talk about fucking chicks, talk about all of this stuff, and I still get money. I'm still free while you're in prison in a job that you hate. Yeah, if I was you, I might hate me too if I wasn't enlightened, because I'm going to do another video, and you should be really looking out for this one, because it's called Why You Can Never Have a Negative Thought. I'm going to blow your mind with that video, so stay tuned for that. But once again, never look to a chipmunk on how to be a dog. I have a list below of new things that are coming, and I'm probably going to do a special today. I haven't made up my mind, but it will be below, and they'll say, hey, Christmas special. So with that, I'll see you people in the next video.
I just noticed you, my queen. You looking like some buttercream. You know exactly what I need. Hot cocoa, sweet and savory. And that's you, that's you. It's true, it's true. And that's you, that's you. You do the things that you do. I just noticed you, my queen. You looking like some buttercream. You know exactly what I need. Hot cocoa, sweet and savory. My boo, it's true, yeah, it's true. And you do, You do, you do the things that you do. I just spotted you from across the room, fixing me a plate, it got me in a mood. What did I do to deserve a woman like you? Something just happens when the night is cool. Got my eyes on you like I'm trying to move through the crowd like I'm apple cider smooth. Before I grab my food, wrap my arms around you, sway for a minute, heaven in this kitchen. My boo, you know it's true, it's so true. And you do, yeah, you do the things that you do. You my hot cocoa on a cold night. You got my heart and you hold tight. I'm a blessed man to call you wife. Don't need no mistletoes, I give you kisses though. My boo, it's true, you do, oh yes, you do the things that you do. And I just noticed you, my queen. You looking like some buttercream. You know exactly what I need. Hot cocoa, sweet and savory. And that's you, that's you, that's you, that's you, that's you, that's you. You know it's true. My hot cocoa, my hot cocoa, my hot cocoa. You do the things that you do, my hot cocoa.